Madam Deputy Rick.
So we had a sort of local government focus when we were looking at this particular session, and I'm not sure whether there's any of us, any of you in this room that's from local government, but I was asked to sort of sum up just because I'm a local government rep here. I know that we started very much late, but I do want to respect the time, and I also want to leave some time for some questions here. So I'm just going to end with this one particular slide, which is really sort of a 10-point summary of what we've been talking about. And so Kim started talking about a guidebook, a very sort of technical approach to stormwater management. And certainly over the last few years, we've been going beyond the guidebook in terms of creating this culture for watershed change and restoration. And so in terms of our summary, I would say as follows. First of all, choose to be enabled. And that's along the lines of our sort of a lunchtime speaker about, you know, the five BCs for BC, and that we make this conscious choice to become enabled, and that we don't have to actually wait for someone to kind of to give us that start. Establish high expectations. We started off with a technical guidebook, and that was our expectations. But went beyond that by creating a shared vision, and this is this legacy of, hey, imagine what your region might look like in 50 years and where you could actually balance land development activities with ecology. Collaborate in terms of regional teams, and align and integrate efforts. And Mike has talked about various things like the tools, software tools, creating an online presence through committees. Communities of interest and that sort of thing. Celebrate innovation and success when you do have those things happen. And as we looked at our green infrastructure roadshow, there were people that really wanted to kind of show off the things that they were doing in terms of the rain gardens that they were producing and green roofs and projects like that. Connect with community advocates, again, with an online presence with our COIs. Develop local government talent. Again, I thought this was going to be a local government type of audience, but there really is a capacity issue there, especially with more suburban municipalities where there's not an awful lot of staff, and a lot of this stuff is really, really complex, and so we need to really kind of help each other. Promote shared responsibility, regardless of whether you're in government or in NGO or in your private sector, we all have a role to play. And when we do that, what will result is that we will change the land ethic for the better. And with that, we will entertain questions. Thank you.